When you're very young, you have a large amount of a certain substance in every one of your cells. This substance is called phosphatidylcholine, and your body will actually make the substance naturally, but can't keep up with its depletion as time goes on. So a fun fact, by the time you're 90, the level of this substance will be less than 10% of what it was or what you had as a child, okay? And this helps to explain how older people have less supple and less soft skin, okay? In other words, more wrinkly skin, possibly. So, what's up, guys? My name is Bion from Mental Health Nation. I'm a fourth year medical student and an aspiring psychiatrist, and I've been personally taking the supplement for about 6 years now, so I do have some basis for what I'm gonna say, at least some personal experience. So what the heck is phosphatidylcholine? It's a lipid or a fat found in your cell membranes, and it's thought to help make cell membranes and cells more pliable, allowing nutrients to come in and toxins go out. And as you age, the level of the substance in the cell wall will diminish, so this can potentially address a major aging process. As you can imagine, as we age and this nutrient diminishes, you can see how it can affect not only just your skin, but potentially every organ in the body, okay? So I'll reference some studies. For example, there's a study in Poland that found a complex made of this phosphatidylcholine, also known as lecithin, and this is a common food additive, so you may see lecithin in the ingredients list for any kind of food. What it actually is pretty much a complex of different kind of phospholipids, with phosphatidylcholine being one of them, and really being the primary one of them. So this is a study in Poland that combined lecithin with something called silymarin, and this had anti-atherosclerotic effects in experimental animals and also improved their liver detoxification abilities. But for this video, and really my channel, we focus on brain health and mental health, and lecithin has been shown in studies to significantly improve recovery from brain trauma and even strokes. Okay, studies have shown that supplementing brain-injured animals and humans with phospholipids has improved recovery time and the degree of their recovery, okay? So there's other studies that have shown phosphatidylcholine can help with things like memory and learning. And lecithin has also been shown to improve recall in age-related memory loss and Alzheimer's dementia. So how this is actually happening is thought to be due to membrane repair, just replacing what is lost over time, or really just replenishing the natural kind of organic form of these cells. So we're basically helping to protect all cell membranes, and because the mitochondria in the cells, the energy factory powerhouses of the cell, also have membranes, it will help protect the mitochondria and really any other organelle inside the cells as well. So where can you actually get phosphatidylcholine? Egg yolks as a food probably has the most concentration of this, but in general, it's gonna be tough to get from your diet. So I think a smart way to go about it is to take some oral supplements. And of course, before starting any supplement, always consult with your doctor before doing so. So phosphatidylcholine can be taken as oral supplement. It's even available in IV form, kind of IV therapy. I haven't researched much into that, but I know in Germany, it's used more common than the US, and it's actually approved by the German equivalent of the FDA. And there's people like Ray Kurzweil, the director of engineering for Google, who actually take IV doses of phosphatidylcholine on a regular basis. But as far as oral supplementation is concerned, the number I've seen to work is about 750 milligrams twice a day. Some potential side effects of the phosphatidylcholine: one is an unwanted one, one is a more desired one. Phosphatidylcholine is thought to convert to the neurotransmitter acetylcholine in the body, which is used by both the brain and muscles. So, you know, kind of going off this, if you have too much choline, you could potentially experience some muscle spasms. And obviously, if you experience some muscle spasms, it's more than your body needs, and you should definitely cut back the dose. But again, before starting this or adjusting anything, always consult with your primary care provider or your doctor. And in terms of the brain, because it can convert to this acetylcholine, which is a neurotransmitter really associated with memory, it can potentially increase brain levels of acetylcholine, which is thought to be low in some diseases like Alzheimer's. So it's possible it could help your memory In fact, that might be one of the reasons why it's been shown to help memory in studies, okay? So thank you for tuning in. If you found this helpful at all, please subscribe for more health hacks, more brain hacks, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.